can you speak directly right now to my audience members who are afraid of getting vaccinated? They just want to wait. They're just not ready. What would you say to them, especially the parents right now?
First of all, for anyone listening who's not vaccinated yet, who's been wondering if it's the right thing for them, who's worried maybe about some of the news that they've heard, or who's had bad experiences with the healthcare system and is worried about whether they can get this vaccine, I first want to say there's nothing wrong with having questions. And if you've got questions, don't be ashamed of that. If you're not vaccinated, it's not a reason to feel, again, ashamed of where you are. What's important is that you're able to get the facts and make the right decision for yourself. And what I want everyone to know out there is that this pandemic, as tough as it's been, is not over yet. And that the Delta variant of COVID, this is more dangerous than anything we've seen before because it is more contagious and it's spreading like wildfire. We've seen the heavy toll it's taken in terms of loss of life. We've also seen that that toll has been disproportionately borne by communities of color. And we know that they've been hit hard, that they've lost more family members, that they've been hospitalized more often. Economically, this has taken a toll as well. And if we want our communities to heal, to get through this, we've got to stop this virus. And the most effective blockade we have against the virus is the vaccines. Here's what you should just know, though. The vaccines, and all the experience we have over the last many months, where we've administered more than 350 million doses of vaccine, here's what we've learned. These are actually remarkably effective. They dramatically drop the chances that you will die or be hospitalized from COVID-19. We've also learned one other critical thing. They're incredibly safe. That the side effects that you may have heard about with the vaccine are incredibly rare. And I say this because, number one, we've got to compare the risk of a rare side effect with the vaccine with what we know is a very clear and present danger of COVID-19 itself, which causes a whole host of problems to not just our lungs, but our heart, to our kidneys, to our nervous system and our brain and to other parts of our body. But I say this also because there's a lot of misinformation out there, and I don't want anybody to fall prey to the misinformation out there. Some of the common myths out there are that COVID-19 vaccine causes COVID-19. And there's also a myth out there that the vaccine causes infertility or mutations in your DNA. And I want to tell you as clearly as I can that those are myths, that they have been debunked, that there's no science to support that at all. And in fact, what we've seen time and time again from the research and the data is that people get pregnant after they get this vaccine. People get the vaccine during pregnancy, early in pregnancy, late in pregnancy. They and their babies do well. And people who have recently had a baby also get vaccinated. And not only do they do well, but as they build antibodies and as they're nursing, they pass antibodies on to their child and they help protect their child as well. So the benefits of vaccination continue to grow. We know that the safety profile remains strong. If you want to know that you can move forward, you know, more confident that you'll be protected, if you want to protect the people around you, especially unvaccinated children, if you want to help our communities get back to normal, getting vaccinated is the most powerful step that you can take today.